Uncle J Canteen. My name is Uncle J. So today's gonna be a bit different. You know, usually my friend will come and then teach me how to cook their own food, right? But today the focus is about Singapore. So I am going to teach someone how to cook Singapore food. Now Singapore, you know, when you talk about Singapore food, many people tell me chicken rice lah, what laksa lah. I tell you all these too commercialized lah. Okay. What Uncle J like is something called prawn mee, okay? Xia mian tang, if you read Chinese, okay? And then I will teach my friend how to make xia mian tang, okay? And my friend is my very, very good friend, okay? Let me invite my my 朋友, my 朋友, Dulanga.
Yo, Uncle J.
Yo!
How's it going?
Yo! Yeah. Okay, my 朋友, where are you from?
I am from the great land of Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka, yes. So, today, we will be doing the prawn mee. Have you tried prawn mee before?
I don't think I've tried prawn mee before. I mean, yeah, I've just had noodles.
Just noodle, okay.
I've had beef mee.
Beef mee?
And indomie.
Indomie not from Singapore, lah. Okay, never mind. Prawn, Sri Lanka got prawn or not?
Sri Lanka got prawns.
Okay. Because, you know, Sri Lanka, what is famous in Singapore is this thing, your crab.
Yeah, crabs in Sri Lanka are amazing.
Yeah.
You have got to try it.
Yeah, they're like, wow, super, super big one, I tell you. Yeah. And then, so if you want to learn how to make this thing, right, and then you want to be a bit atas, right, yeah, or become a bit high class, like, sometimes people will put, like, crab, lah, but I don't want to teach you how to make all these, because we are very, very low class, okay. We have a few ingredients I need to teach and share you, okay? So we prepare a little bit already, otherwise we cook until tomorrow, so never finish. So first of all, what do we have? Let's start with this. Okay? So, what do you think this is?
You got the shells and the heads of prawns for some reason.
Yes, okay. We're not gonna eat this, of course. We don't eat like prawn meat, and then we don't eat the prawn shell like this is just for the taste only, okay? And then we have this pork. And then you see it's a bit interesting, white one, is because just now we pre-cooked a little bit, and then just to get rid of the water.
So you like boiled it?
Yeah. A little bit. Yeah. Okay. Save time. And then, this one is my favorite.
Onions, great stuff.
Onion, the small onion, I think you call shallots or something like that. Those are more, they like to call everything a very, very fancy name. This one don't need any. This one?
That is bok choy.
Bok choy, wrong la. What is this you can see before?
That's tough, this is tough. Uncle, you know so many.
Of course lah, uncle. What thing don't
How
have?
How old are you, uncle?
You don't need to know lah. Uncle, a lot of experience.
Oh, bean sprout.
Yeah, okay.
I know.
You say bean sprout in Singapore, people think you crazy. I'll tell you how to call this. This is called tauge.
Tauge.
Yeah. Tauge is boss. Tauge.
Yeah, yeah.
So tauge is bean sprout.
In Singapore, am I an anmo too?
No, you're not ang mo.
Okay.
Yeah, ang mo is like those like white. You know what ang mo means? Ang mo basically means red hair.
Red hair.
Yeah, like but red hair here lah, so ang mo lah.
Oh, okay, like a redneck.
No. What is redneck? No, ang mo basically like this like white guys, you know, go people lah.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Then this is okay. Tauge, we call it tauge.
Tauge, you want
to try? Don't try it. Later you got food poisoning, not my problem. What is this?
That is I have no idea.
Okay. This one is called gang gong.
Yeah.
Gang gong. You can try pronouncing it.
Gang gong.
Yeah, gang gong.
Did I say it right, uncle?
Huh?
Yeah.
So tauge, gang gong.
Tauge and gang gong.
Okay. Then we still have this thing, the
shrimp.
The shrimp lah, prawn lah. Okay. And then let me ask you, how do Hong Kong prawn laugh?
Hong Kong prawns laugh like ha ha ha.
Yeah.
One right.
Yes. Hong Kong prawn very smart. Hong Kong prawn you know, ha ha ha. Okay, never mind. Anyway, then next we have this thing called fish cake.
Fish cake? I've had fish cake before.
Yeah.
I like fried fish cake.
Fried fish cake?
Yeah.
Oh, this one is already like half fried lah.
No.
Okay, and then we put on top later. Yeah. Okay, and then last but not least, we have this thing, the
me.
Yeah, the yellow noodle lah, the me lah, where yeah. the prawn me, the me, you know, prawn plus me, and then sometimes we got put a bit of what we call kuay tiao.
Okay. Udon.
Not udon, it's like a flat white noodle, kuay tiao. Yeah, yeah. yeah. And then so sometimes you can mix lah. Yeah. Some people don't want, they just put like the me. Mm-hmm. Some people they like, they mix a little bit. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Up to you.
Okay.
And so today we are gonna start off the whole cooking session, okay? Mm. Very simple. We will have to heat up the wok first.
Yeah.
Okay, so
let's
how do you switch on the
Do I just turn that?
Yeah, you turn on and then you put like the lighter. Wait, let me check. Okay. If the lighter cannot make it. Oh yeah, okay. Yeah, okay then. Then
So uncle, what's in this?
Yeah, this one later we'll put like all the so the idea is we cook the prawn shell.
Yeah.
Then now we cook until very very nice smell. Yeah, then we throw everything inside.
Yeah.
Then we put like some pork and everything. Then you make it the soup. This
wonderful,
is for the soup.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So we heat a little bit. Make sure sweet sweet. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then, okay. At the same time, let me boil the water. And hot pot. Okay, like that. Okay. It will keep boiling now. Okay. So. Okay, feel very hot. You take this, you in charge.
Okay, I'm in charge a little bit.
Yeah. Then, you need to wait for it to heat.
Can I stir it?
Yeah. Up to you.
Can I stir it?
Oh, Dulang Gai, I want to ask you a question. You got cooked before?
I cook spaghetti.
Spaghetti. Wow. So atas.
What's atas?
Atas means you are very high class. So you cook spaghetti is high class.
So in Singapore, spaghetti is high class.
Singapore spaghetti, you know, is this Western food.
But I feel like in Hong Kong, like spaghetti is like just the cheap stuff.
Oh yes. I also feel the same. Here in Hong Kong, they just throw everything in and then cook, right? But in Singapore, it's a bit atas lah. Mm-hmm. I would say, you know, you put buy in like Western restaurant and then Then what we're gonna do now is to fry the onion,
the shallots.
Okay, I need to fry until it's golden. Then we take it out. Wow,
That smells good.
Okay, then you keep stirring. Oh, I remember, right? Last month, I learned from Nelumi about Sri Lankan food. Then you guys have this thing called Pol roti,
yeah.
Yeah, and then you also put a lot of onion inside.
Yeah. Pol roti means coconut flatbread, but yeah, we put onions and we put a bunch of things.
Yeah.
I don't like it with all those additives.
Oh.
I like just the pure bread.
Okay, and then the sini sambo also, Yeah, a lot. Continue stirring. Don't look at me later. Later the thing chow ta.
Uncle is so strict.
Yeah, later the thing chow ta is your problem, not my problem.
Uncle, do you have kids?
Uncle play too much lah. Where got kids?
Uncle, what do you play?
Play with a lot of things lah. Don't say too much. Don't say my secret. Okay. Not bad. Fry maybe like maybe 1 more minute or so lah. Then should be okay.
It's kind of brown now.
Okay. Then you take out the shallots. You put at the side first.
Okay. How do I take out just the shallots? Okay.
This one right later we use it as a we put on top garnish. Okay.
Yeah.
But now with the oil, now you got the onion inside the oil, right? So it's very nice smell, right? Then we need to 重头戏来了, okay? We need to fry the prawn shell. Okay? So now we need to put back the prawn shell, okay?
Put
it in, then you cook until become red color.
Yeah.
Important for this to be as dry as possible.
Yeah. Whoa, Uncle Jay.
Yeah.
So Uncle Jay, do you how often do you eat this at home in Singapore?
So right, good question, Dulanga. So I eat like maybe once every 2 weeks
Once every two weeks.
Yeah. You cannot eat a lot because the soup, you every day eat prawn high cholesterol. You know Uncle Jay got some age already Then you stay healthy okay.
Yeah. So Uncle, what do you eat? What's your main, most common dish? What do you eat the most in Singapore?
I eat the most is something called cai feng.
Chai Peng.
Yeah. So Chai Peng means right, rice and it's like vegetable rice.
Yeah.
Where you go and pick like 2-3 different vegetable or meat and then you put together on top of the rice and then that's it.
So fried rice.
No, the rice is white rice.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a lot like in Sri Lanka, like we just have rice with some vegetables and maybe a curry.
Like side dish.
Yeah.
You can see the prawn is starting to dry up. The prawn shell is starting to dry up and then it become red. And it smells quite nice, right?
Yeah.
Got a very, very, very prawn smell lah. Uncle Jay like prawn a lot. Yeah, prawn. Okay. So now we are fried until like okay, sweet already not bad And then now we gonna put like some hot like water inside.
Oh, pop water into this.
Yeah. Okay. So must be careful. If you are. Wow, actually it's quite
so
a nice.
So what's
smell.
This for?
This one? Oh, this one I want to make it's for me to make a halal version. Okay. Put it there first. We put it somewhere here, we let it wait. Then now, now we gotta put the pork in, okay? Then it enhance the flavor.
Uncle Jay
is
gonna touch the raw pork now.
Oh yeah.
Uncle Jay, this is Singaporean style.
Yeah, never mind.
Certified.
Use hand. You want to do it?
No, I'm good.
Do you eat pork in your country?
Most people eat fish or chicken in Sri Lanka. Pork and beef is really like not that popular. Mm. Mostly because many of the Buddhists and Hindus don't want to eat beef, and then the Muslims don't want to eat pork. So, yeah.
Well, they got to find a middle, middle ground, lah.
Yeah, the middle ground is fish and chicken. And also it's an island, so there's fish everywhere.
Boil like 20 minutes. And then in the meantime we will wash, we will change the noodle, put some water. We're gonna cook the noodles. Okay. So we're gonna put some. Uncle Jay really hates this electric stove.
So Uncle, how's this doing?
Not bad, but it needs to maybe a bit more, you need to boil a bit more. The more you boil, then the more taste you will have.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah. And maybe we can cover the thing first. Wait. Cover it. Later all the water escape there. I have to put water in again. Yeah.
What's this?
This one?
Yeah.
Good question. This is not diamond. This is the rock sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so my father tell me when you want to flavor the soup, right? Because now the soup don't have any flavor.
Yeah.
So we're gonna put a bit of the rock sugar, mm-hmm. and then a bit of the salt.
Yeah. Okay. A bit of the salt.
Yeah. A bit of the salt, the rock sugar, and then maybe put a little bit of the soya sauce, the dark mm-hmm. soya sauce here.
Yeah.
Then the flavor will come out.
Right. Okay. Yeah. So that's salt and that's rock sugar.
Yeah. Correct. Yeah.
Chop
up. Yeah. Banga, just like. You want to use, you use your hand and put just like I touch the pork, I don't want to touch the noodle.
Yeah.
Don't put everything in
Okay, I will not put everything in.
You mix.
So I'm scared, it's kind of wet, wet and slimy stuff.
Boti you. What? You know what's boti?
I don't know what boti is.
Boti means you no ball.
Ball?
Yeah, no ball.
What ball?
Go what ball? What kind of ball do you have?
I have tennis balls, basketball.
You know what I'm talking la,
football.
You know, we call it if you are very, don't want to do anything, everything is just scared, we say you boji.
Ah, okay. So I'm gonna push that under using these chopsticks.
Can. Wow, Dulanga, I must say your chopstick skills is better than me.
Thank you.
Uncle Jay use chopstick every time my mother will hit my hand on it.
Yeah, my family had chopsticks too, but we used them more as decoration.
For what? Put on the wall.
Put in the middle of the table.
Yeah, oh, like, wow. This is guitar, I know you're atas. Chopstick as a decoration, yeah.
Wow, I think it's common in Sri Lanka.
Oh, already, yeah.
Because no one can use it, so you see these chopsticks and then you buy them and just decorate your house.
Oh, that's really cool, man. You buy like a normally chopstick and then you put it at home and then you become like a decoration.
Yeah.
Wow, this is amazing. I never hear anyone use chopstick as a decoration before. Okay, so we've been boiling this for 20 minutes, is it?
A long time.
Yeah, super long time. Very sad. Wait until my neck long. Okay, then now what we're gonna do, we gotta cook the prawn a little bit, okay? But you don't want to just throw everything in, because then you cannot find them again.
Right, yeah.
You know, just like I cannot find my girlfriend anymore.
Yeah.
So you take the... Take the leaf out and put somewhere.
Put here.
Yeah. Then let it keep while it's boiling. And then maybe you can take some of the prawn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then you put onto the...
This one?
Yeah, you put some inside here.
Okay. You want me to touch that?
Yeah. Okay, so now let's take away all those...
take away the shell.
The shell, yeah, because okay. we don't want the shell. You don't take out my pork, okay?
Shells?
Let me check. Okay, you got any pork inside here, I'm going to kill you.
What's your ideal way of killing people, Uncle?
Huh? Uncle Jin. Uncle Jin don't kill people, man. Uncle Jin will talk until you want to kill yourself.
Is that why Singapore has such a high suicide rate, Uncle?
God, man. you don't anyhow say, okay, later the government come and catch you.
So, Uncle, how's a Singaporean government like?
Wow, this kind of thing you ask me to say in front of the camera, you want me to die, man, huh? I love my country a lot.
Yeah, I bet you do.
The best in the world. Okay?
Best in with the newspaper.
Hey, can you chop hurry up or not? My grandma can do this faster than you, you know.
Oh, so uncle's grandma is still alive.
Don't talk so much. Yeah, don't take my soup out too. I need the soup. You take out all the soup, then what we
it's
eat?
It's just a few milliliters, uncle. Calm down.
You make me then big check, you know or not.
This is a very thorough, complicated process. Surgery.
Okay. I know you're a princess, Aga, can you eat? Wait, why are you shaking?
Uncle Jay, you'll get Alzheimer's in the future.
What is Alzheimer's?
It's a very posh condition.
So that means I become very...
Very smart, yeah.
Okay. Then we all have Alzheimer's together, okay?
Yeah, let's have Alzheimer's too.
Then we keep it here. Then we let it keep boiling. Okay, then at the same time, I think we can put the prawns in and cook.
Yeah.
Don't need to cook a lot. Like maybe...
5 minutes.
No lah, 30 seconds can already.
30 seconds?
Yeah. 30 seconds, 40 seconds. You know, like, you don't want to cook until the prawn become like shrimp, right?
Okay. Gonna put the prawns in now. Just one by one?
Yeah, put it in. Got the flavor come out.
There we go.
Yeah. And then put it in first, and then let it cook first. Then at the same time, right, we need to flavor the soup. So we use a bit of this rock sugar.
Right.
You put.
Okay. Yeah. Just gonna drop it there. Yeah.
And then you gonna let it melt out, of course. Then sometimes we'll put a bit of the just a little bit of this like
soy sauce,
let's use this. Just a little bit dark soy sauce like around here lah, just to enhance the flavor a little bit, okay, otherwise no taste one. Wow, sweet. Okay, then after that we put, you taste you want to taste, then you let me know how's the taste. We can put, then we start putting a bit of salt, should have no taste one.
Okay.
No taste, right? Yeah, then we have to put a bit of salt. Enhance the taste a little bit.
Okay.
actually, I don't know how much salt to put.
Also, just agar agar one. Okay, boil, stir. The prawn should be almost done. Then we stir a bit first.
So, what's your earliest childhood food memory?
Wow, such a good question. I got something called earliest childhood. I think I got something called nasi lemak.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think I was like primary school.
Yeah.
They were only selling for like what 50 cents Singapore dollars. So maybe like what $3 Hong Kong dollars.
Yeah.
And then I remember going to school and then my mom would buy one pack for me to eat.
Every day?
No lah. Like maybe once a month.
Okay. So your mom took you to school?
Mm-hmm. By bus. By I go bus. To school by bus.
Alone?
Hmm?
By yourself?
School bus ma.
Ah, oh, okay.
Yeah. School bus.
How far was your school from home?
How far was the school by home? If I walk, 15 minutes can reach.
And you still took the bus?
Yeah, because it's safer ma. Put a bit more salt now. Wait. Just to enhance the flavor.
How old were you when you started taking the MRT by yourself?
Ah, the MRT ah. I think when uncle, like primary 6.
Which is
12 years old. Mm. You got take MRT before or not?
I've taken MRT before, yeah.
You seem like the person that will have a lot of cars at home, right?
No.
Okay. I
live in a small room.
Okay. I believe you. Yeah, that should be okay already. You want to check the taste again?
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah. Use another. I can. Anything? Is it better? Or should we need? I think we need a little bit more.
Ooh, that is much better. Yeah.
Much better, right? Okay. Then, we can put the fire off soon. Okay. Let it keep boiling a little bit. Okay. And then, what we're gonna do is we're gonna put some of the prawn, this
fish cake
inside too. Yeah. Okay. Just let it cook a little bit enhance the flavor. This one, I think 1 minute later, we can take out. Yeah. Sugar. Salt. This last part is the worst. I'm very bad at seasoning.
Uncle. No.
You never see.
You're gonna get thyroid cancer.
You never see.
You know what thyroid cancer is,
what
Uncle?
What is thyroid cancer?
It's when you have too much iodine in your system.
Wow, sweet, yeah, good. Mm. Tastes better. Yeah. Okay, then we are done. Then let's take out. What we're gonna do, we gotta put the noodles into the bowl, and then we pour the then what are you doing? We put the noodles into the bowl, then we put the soup inside, and then we put like some of the vegetables in, and then done.
Yeah,
we put the
I can feel Uncle J's love.
Yes. Okay. Then we put the I must take out. Oh, you see my prawn become like my prawn become like stream already there. Okay, then we put the thing in. Okay. Let me put some bean sprouts in. Kang kong in. So wow, become yellow already my kang kong. Yeah. Give you a bit of very generous. I give you more prawn.
Thank you.
Now I put a little bit here. Yeah, this one will enhance the flavor later. It's the prawn mee, the prawn soup, okay, from Singapore. And so if you want, you can learn how to cook, okay, but I suggest you also look online YouTube, okay, maybe the recipe is better. Yeah. Like Uncle Jay, you know, we we anyhow cook one. So you want to put your flavor and agar agar, okay? So better go online and search. But hope it looks like legit, okay?
Yeah, like your mom's, right?
Yeah, but doesn't taste like my mom.
Yeah.
Okay, so now Dulanga, you will help me to taste this.
Yep.
And let me know what you think.
Looks delicious. So here we go. First for the noodles.
Wow, Gordon Ramsay.
It has a slight fishy taste. Also kind of slimy. I like it.
Yeah.
Ooh, the soup is delicious.
Yeah.
I can feel the prawn. I can feel all the spices together. It's amazing. I recommend that you go to Uncle Jay's canteen and have this tomorrow.
Yes. So anyway, this is the prawn mee, okay, that I want to share with you guys. So if you ever go to like Singapore, don't just go and get chicken rice or laksa or I don't know, kaya toast or something like that, okay. Prawn mee is also a very good taste, okay. You can find almost anywhere in any hawker center. If you want to cook yourself, all these ingredients can be found in Hong Kong as well, okay. But what will make it better is if you got something called like the pork lard, the pork fat, you can fry it and then you got the more taste.
So don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, subscribe to us on YouTube, and go to our website at icehongkong.com.
Thank you, Dulanga, and see you!
Bye!